People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, today I have some breaking news for you. A major discovery. One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Like, forget about gold and oil and diamonds and all these other discoveries. People, this right now is the most shocking thing you'll have heard in the last 100 years. People, it turns out that there are senior police officers in the Jamaica Constabulary Force that are tipping off guns about impending operations against them. I'm going to give you some time to soak in that information because I'm sure it's brand new to everybody and nobody didn't know this at all. So let me just give you some time to soak that in. People, fun and joke aside, who does the Jamaica Constabulary Force think they must surprise with this news? Because what we're hearing now is that inspector of police, the specs, you know, brown suit, big salary, yes, there is a Don in Jamaica who the Gleaner didn't name, but I'm guessing it must be a fairly heavy Don, because Uncle Sam is actually involved, right? And it turns out that Uncle Sam and the JCF were planning to launch a raid or a sting against this Don, right? And people, this is where things start to get really interesting. See, it turns out this Don or this individual is so international that there was a meeting called, right? And check this, people. There were high-ranking officials, not just from Uncle Sam, right, but also from British and Canadian law enforcement agencies. So Jamaica, America, Britain, and Canada came together to plan a strategy or to plan an operation to bring down this, I'm guessing, high level 90 octane, could be a 116, right? And his operation. Now, this senior police inspector, right, he was actually invited to the meeting. Right, and he sat there and he heard the plans that were going to be used against this individual. Right, so him sit down, soak up all the information, get all him can get, and as soon as the meeting was done, he jumped on his phone and him called this criminal and tell him about what was going to happen. Hold on, people, it keeps getting better. Right, now it turns out that this criminal and the policeman end up fall out over some other foolishness. So, because him tip off the man, obviously, them know I get to catch him, right? But the Don and the inspector end up fall out over some other foolishness, right? And after being upset about this separate incident, the Don then linked the police to tell them, said this inspector tipped him off. People, I wonder if you realize how criminal life work. What does normal civilians get dashed with for left, right, and center? Talking to the police, right? When the Don here say I talk to the police, him send man come do this to you and do this to you. You remember what happened to that daughter, that mother and daughter over there in St. Catherine, right? Fling with the woman and her daughter head because she talked to police, or allegedly I talked to police. Now you see what happened? Just because the Don of a falling out with this police, he then linked the police and admitted that, hey, you know, say, remember the time only the thing could not come catch me, only plan operation, you know, so him tip me off. So you're probably thinking, oh, well, that's the climax. Oh, no, people, this story keeps on getting better. Because, you see, when the police find out that he was the one who tipped off this criminal, so him could have get away from the operation, they then planned a second operation to catch him. So basically, this inspector was supposed to meet up with this Don, right, to collect $300,000 payment for his help in making the man get away from the original sting operation, right? But this time, this second operation was being carried out by JCF. Major red flag. Without reading any more of the story, I could have already said this not gonna go out plan, right? Trust me, people. JCF does not have an amazing record of pulling off sting operations, especially by themselves, right? So hear this now, no? Hear the cartoon thing now. The man was supposed to collect the money from somebody, right? But then when the police then move in upon him, he ran and disposed of the evidence. This is what the article say. And in brackets, them put marked notes. So it looked like they marked some money, right? And then obviously when they catch him with it, they would have evidence to say, well, see it, this money is marked. This money was for collect payments to help him get away from the sting operation, right? Now, people, before we go any further, let me tell you my opinion on what happened right here, sir. It's very likely this inspector was again tipped off by another police about this second operation. Now listen to me. People, this second operation that was supposed to catch him, he probably got tipped off by another police that the man him level come for him. What do they mean he ran and disposed of the... Hold on, is he Usain Bolt? Alright, imagine a sting operation. First of all, I'm assuming, right, boy, you can never really be sure with JCF, but I'm assuming the operation was planned somewhere where I'm guessing he doesn't have a river next to him or a sea where he can chuck off, you know, right? So, how far am I running, people? What do they mean he ran and disposed of the money? How far and how fast could he run? Right? To the point where they couldn't catch him and them couldn't even see where the money go. When the operation, I'm guessing, would have been done with a hand-to-hand basis. You'd have man park up over here, so I watch him, and man park up down the road, I watch him. But then again, people, you know what? Maybe we're giving them too much credit. Again, this is JCF and their track record is not amazing. I'm just saying that's normally how I see sting operations happen in the movie. So I'm guessing there were multiple men posted at different parts. So I'm gonna know how man must collect money and then run off to the point where nobody couldn't catch him, right? Nobody couldn't see where him dashed the money, so the money couldn't be recovered. A matter of fact, they shouldn't arrest this man. This man needs to be representing Jamaica at the next Olympics. Clearly this man on Jamaica time must be down in the 4 second category, right? Because more, me still want to know how a man can run. Running up people, not drive off or chucking at the scene or run from a sting operation until this day, then they catch him in the money. Right, but anyway, people, it turns out that JCF is saying, right, that them can't prosecute him. Right? Because if they did prosecute him, they would have to expose the quote top shelf crime fighting tools the JCF wants to keep under wraps. Let me say that again, people. The JCF is saying they cannot prosecute this Cena cop because they would have to expose the top shelf crime fighting tools the JCF wants to keep under wraps. Man, shut up. I call now on a friend. Which top secret tools? I don't have no top secret tools. Why don't they use them already? Which top secret crime fighting tools? You couldn't even pull off a basic sting operation. Listen, I could take 5 of my subscribers, any random 5, male, female, any age, and we can set up a sting operation, right? We could set a dragnet where the inspector couldn't get away from me. 5, I just need 5 of them, right? I know them are going to tell you them have top shelf crime fighting tools to keep on the wraps, because according to them, they would have to disclose all the evidence in their possession to the lawyer for the policeman, and that would expose some of the methods they used to obtain it. What are they talking about? This was a sting operation. This is how it would work. This is how they done with doing. Remember, the phone will be tapped, right? So phone tapping is nothing new and revolutionary. So it couldn't be that. They might worry they might got exposed to people because everybody knows that your phone can get tapped. Everybody knows that digital have access to all your phone records and the government can get access to it. Right, as we saw in the cartel case. So it can't be that they might try hide. So the Donnie that say, yo, Specs, big up for help me with the, you know, forget it from them Yankee boy there, you know. You know, send me a 300,000 for you. Specs say, yeah man, anytime man, you don't know me do my thing already. Alright, meet me at half a tree right here, so by the clock. Alright. Then they mark the notes. When Specs turn up to collect the money, right? Then right there they have on record the agreement that the money is for this criminal act and the collecting of the money. Case done, you know, people. That's all them need to prove the case in a court, you know. What they mean, them can't prosecute the man. I'll tell you why them can't prosecute the man. because them probably because the man probably gonna start call some name. Any other inspector going to court, he probably start leak like an ice truck, worse than Ratty. He probably turn Ratty times two. He probably turn Master Splinter in a Ninja Turtles. Right? So that is why them no one draw him up. Because this high level officer have them secret, and if he may touch the stand, he'd go roll. Right? So it turns out the cop, when he realized pressure reach him now, tried to escape. Well, not escape, because it's not like he was going to be prosecuted. But decided he might go left the island, you know, cool out. When he reached out to Norman Manley, people, guess what happened to him? Uncle Sam take away him visa. Man stranded, man turned penguin. But we don't know the name of the Dan, and we don't know the name of the inspector. People, Jamaica. Jamaica is just a ruling Hollywood movie, right? Forget about Hollywood, because I make them make up things. This is real life, right? Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.